Are these cool glasses?
Yes. Have a pair.
Welcome to 100 years of Rotary. Now sit back, relax, and let me take you there. Autumn, 1915. Francis Edward Bumstead, owner of a small plumbing and heating business, planning to organize a Rotary Club in Colorado Springs. His first step is to convene a meeting of some 50 business and professional men at the Acacia Hotel. Rotary International was resistant because at that time, the city's population was under 30,000, much less than Rotary International's unwritten requirement of at least 50,000 for a city to have a Rotary Club. Nevertheless, largely thanks to Bumstead and the Pueblo Rotary who sponsored us, the formation of the club was accomplished. At a meeting at the Alamo Hotel on February 26, 1916, the district governor from Denver presented the charter to the Rotary Club of the Pikes Peak region. Club number 218 entered the International Association of Rotary Clubs. Imagine the district governor and Francis Bumstead in that moment 100 years ago.
Mr. Francis Edward Bumstead, as the district governor from the great town of Denver, Colorado, I am pleased to present you with the charter for the Rotary Club of the Pikes Peak region. You are club number 218 in the International Association of Rotary Clubs.
Oh, thank you, sir. I promise that I will work hard to uphold the principles of Rotary and to make sure that my members do the same. This is such an honor. Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you, sir.
You know, we made a big exception to grant you this charter. Colorado Springs is so small. We prefer to have our Rotary clubs in much larger towns.
I know, sir. But you know how hard I've worked to make this happen. We will make you proud. Now, may I buy you a bourbon? There's a fine bar just around the corner.
The membership that first year numbered 53. Francis Bumstead pronounced, "As new as I am to Rotary principles and as green as I am, I want to say, I love it and feel in starting this organization that I have grafted an influence that will produce better men and better living." So, 1916, what was Rotary then? Their directory stated, "A Rotary Club is a group of business and professional men who have accepted the Rotary philosophy of service and seek success in business and in life." Meetings were held at the Alamo Hotel, and the meals cost 50 cents a plate. The diversity of occupations in the first club included a funeral director, Fred Crissy in lumber, remember Crissy Fowler? A typewriter salesman, a banker, a cattle breeder, a merchant of canvas goods, an insurance salesman, a men's clothier, a photographer, and of course, Matt Whitney selling electric supplies. 1916, the highest inner city meeting ever held by any Rotary Club in any part of the world was convened at the top of Pikes Peak. Clubs from Denver to Pueblo attended with 100% attendance. 1917, the Rotary Club got to work with the Big Brothers program, and all were paired with boys from Juvie. 1917, World War I was in full swing while this new club was trying to get off the ground. As the U.S. entered the war, membership decreased substantially when Rotarians enlisted. Rotary rose to the call to contribute in many ways to the war effort. Imagine the Rotarians going off to war. Club of the Putts Peak Region moved its meeting to the El Paso Club and changed its name to the Rotary Club of Colorado Springs. In 1919, Rotary was again called upon to help, this time with the Great Pueblo Flood. The flood caused over $20 million in property damage and thousands left homeless. Later in 1919, the mayor came to Rotary to speak on the possibility of paving the streets in Colorado Springs. Membership is now growing. We're up to 100 members. In 1921, there were frequent baseball games with the Kiwanis Club, including a band for entertainment. The club in that year also held its own meeting at the top of Pikes Peak. Round trip cost $1.62 per person. You've just heard about Rotarians, the spouses of Rotarians. Well, in 1923, a new tradition fitting for the Roaring Twenties was to devote a Friday each month to ladies' night, replacing a weekly meeting. Dress was formal with fine dining and dancing. Bet you are back there in time.
Of course you are, my dear. Let's keep dancing.
An interesting note. The only meetings throughout the year that were canceled were those that fell exactly on July 4, December 25, or July 4th. Wait till you hear what these Rotarians did for Christmas Eve. Well, in 1935, an annual Christmas party was given for the Bethel crippled children, always on Christmas Eve, and that tradition lasted for years. You see, Rotary had adopted the Bethel Hospital for Crippled Children. Rotarians took responsibility to care for 21 crippled children and aid them in becoming useful citizens. Another tradition from 1935 was a twice a year joint meeting held with Kiwanis and Lions. In 1939, membership was up to 98 people, 98 men. In 1940, Rotary began sponsoring the Boy Scouts. 1943, with U.S. involvement in World War II, programs at every meeting related to the war. For example, Hitler sold the railroads short. Appeal for clothing for destitute Russian war prisoners. The battle on the home front. psychopathic casualties in the armed forces, the Navy V-12 program, medical care in the Air Force, and so forth. By 1950, membership was up to 154. We kept tab on this all the way. In 1951, Rotary became very active in international service. In 53, Rotary returns to the Acacia Hotel. Rotarians were fascinated by a program featuring a demo of the dial system of the telephone. And party lines. And they also beheld quite an improvement in movies called Technicolor. In 55, Rotarians established the Crippled Children's Camp and also began foreign student exchange programs. Membership is at 189. In 57, Rotary started an annual program of entertainment from the band of the Colorado Springs High School. That's now Palmer High School. It was the best program of the year. In 59, here's a small sample of more of these interesting programs that Rotarians enjoyed. A psychiatrist looks at Rotary. The head coach of the new United States Air Force Academy. Antique cars, the Metropolitan Opera. About retarded children. That was the phraseology back then. North American Air Defense. An unusual film of an around the world cruise underwater of the atomic powered Titan submarine. The manufacture of steel, the impact of the National Western Stock Show with farmers and ranchers invited as guests. And finally, Christmas in Foreign Lands by a panel of Rotarians from Germany, Norway, and China. That's in 59. 1964, World Understanding Week was initiated with a combined meeting of all regional Rotary clubs. Today we know this as World Peace and Understanding Week. 1966, of course, you do your math. The 50th anniversary celebration was held at the Broadmoor Hotel. 337 people attended, and the past president of Rotary International was the speaker. Custom candles were made for the event, so when the lights dimmed, listen to this, fellas. The men sang sweetheart songs to their Rotary aunts. Rotarians whom you may know or remember who spoke to the club not so very long ago. In 1966, General Ken Curtis spoke on India. In 1967, Professor Frank Tucker of Colorado College described perspectives emanating from Communist China. Also in 1967, Harlan Oakes, then member of the District 11 School Board, outlined the education complex in Colorado Springs. In 68, Dr. John Cunning recounted a boat trip down the Colorado River through the Grand Canyon. In 69, Guy Cressup, then assistant manager of the Credit Bureau of Colorado Springs, explained the operation of a credit bureau. And in 73, David Supperstein presented a program on the Steel Warehousing Association. Programs remain a core enrichment activity of our club. And by 94, membership reached 195. In 79, we learned about hospice, a brand new program for the terminally ill. In 1980, dues were increased from $75 to $85 a year. That's all. Rotarians continue to enliven the meetings themselves. 1982, the musical program by Marv Thomason singing excerpts from Camelot. In 1982, also Leslie Cook, then assistant director of the Pikes Peak chapter of the Red Cross, demonstrated CPR. not on one of our members. In 1984, the homeless population in the city was getting to be a problem. With the generosity of member Raya Waltman, the city purchased her big warehouse for a song, with the plan to make it into a warm shelter for these homeless folks and their families. At that time, it was known as the Red Cross Shelter. The building needed a ton of work. Rotary stepped up with their labor and dollars and made it what it is today, a place of refuge on those very cold nights. It is now operated by the Salvation Army. In 1985, as Dennis mentioned, Rotary International launches Polio Plus, its campaign to get rid of polio in the world. 30 years later, the number of cases of polio worldwide has dropped from over 350,000 to under 100. Three cheers for Rotary. It was in 1987 when the U.S. Supreme Court ruled that Rotary could not exclude women from membership based on their gender. Rotary International issues a policy statement that year that any Rotary club in the United States can admit qualified women into membership. The qualifier in the United States has meaning if you travel internationally. I can tell you about that. In 1988, Sister Myra James, head of Glockner Penrose Sanitarium, and the late, great Leslie Cook were brought into the Rotary Club by two local dignitaries. This invasion of the fairer sex was a bit of a joke. At the luncheons, at first, men ignored the ladies. Not out of disrespect, they just were stumped when it came to having a casual conversation with ladies. The North Rotary Club reacted a little differently. When the ladies appeared on the roster and attended the luncheon meeting, half the club walked out, never to return. Can you imagine the horror on the faces of the men with the invasion of the ladies?
Sister, isn't this wonderful that we're finally being admitted to Rotary? I'm just thrilled.
Yes, this is such an honor. But why are the men acting so strange? They won't talk to us, and they try not to sit with us.
I don't know what's wrong with them. They act like they've never been around a woman in their lives. We're not going to bite them.
Maybe they think we'll be taking over the club. They need to get over it.
Yes, they do. Let's just enjoy our lunch and ignore them right back. They can be rude all they want. We're not going anywhere, right?
Right.
Turned out to be an 8-year run of, at that time, one of the club's most successful fundraisers, Artists of the West. This was very popular and brought in about $20,000 each year for our community service projects. 1990 was the beginning of a much anticipated holiday tradition, the visit of Santa Claus inside our club at a club meeting, who always made a grand entrance on his red motor scooter. Santa knew who had been good and who had not, and offered gifts accordingly, sort of pay-up time. In 1996, we welcomed our first woman president, Mary Jean Larson. Skepticism greeted her. A woman president? But one Friday, Mary Jean arrived early to Rotary, bellied up to the Antlers bar with the guys, ordered a martini, enjoyed it to the less drunk, and some say it was a game changer. In 2002, an old building on South Weber Street was acquired by the Colorado Veterans Resource Coalition, which had been formed to help homeless and substance abusing veterans. The building, again, was a mess. In a project championed by Dr. Stephen Kidd, Rotarians stepped up with paintbrushes and hammers and helped to renovate the building into the very successful Crawford House that it is today. It was a labor of love. Approximately 200 veterans are helped here each year. Can't you just see our Rotarians covered in paint and sawdust?
Hey, Joe, can you hold this cabinet while I nail it in place?
Sure, how's this?
Ow! You hit me with your hammer!
Sorry.
Ow! You did it again! Sorry!
Jack Kinney and his band of helpers organized the Diamond Awards, a program recognizing distinguished high school teachers from District 11 nominated by the students themselves. To date, we've honored 79 outstanding D11 teachers. In 2006, our club funded and built the Freedom Memorial to honor military members who paid the ultimate price. The memorial stands in Memorial Park on the Ring of Valor, featuring a view of Pikes Peak and Prospect Lake. Many displays and remembrances are left at that site in the form of flowers and cards to a mom or a dad or a brother or a daughter who will never return home. In 2008, Tony Serrato busted into our Rotary Club. He came to the club's board meeting where Jack Donnelly presided with an idea for a fabulous fundraiser that he'd seen in Green Bay, Wisconsin. Our first event grossed over $40,000. We've hosted the event every year since that first gala. The most recent Butterflies and Friends, now known as Flight, grossed over $147,000. Way to go, Tony. And all of the chairs of this most successful event. Our most recent chairman extraordinaire was Jason Aguilar. Sadly, Tony left us last year and moved to Arizona to be closer to family. Gone, but not forgotten. Wouldn't you like to have seen Tony presenting his idea to the board?
Hey, Jack, I have this great idea for a fundraiser for the club. We're gonna sell butterflies.
Butterflies? Real butterflies?
Of course not, Jack. Beautiful artistic metal butterflies. Listen, they did it in Wisconsin and made a ton of money.
Yeah, right. They did. Really?
We make the butterflies and artists paint them and then we sell them.
You're kidding. You can't be serious.
Come on, Jack. It'll be great.
Oh, Tony, I just don't know.
Come on, Jack.
Tony even had a ponytail when he first appeared. In 2013, a new and younger version of Rotarians sprang up, Rotary Prime. Very enthusiastic guys and gals, age 40 and under, have brought copious new energy, as you can tell, and ideas to our club. They meet separately in the evening each week, but often come to our Friday luncheons. So now we arrive at 2016. Rotary is now so involved in so many service projects. Shelter boxes, champions, diamond awards, high school scholarships, Philharmonic project, dental project, Crawford House, foreign exchange students. blankets for the homeless, Santa Day at Queen Palmer Elementary, Griffith Backpack Project for children, Nuevo Casas Grandes projects in Mexico, Salvation Army Bell Ringers, Mock Trial, just to name a few. Francis Edward Bumstead would be proud. Here we are now, 100 years later. After all you've heard, just what is Rotary?